Okay, as I finished the last part of the lecture, we were talking about the characteristic impedance. The characteristic impedance, Z naught, is equal to V0 plus divided by I0 plus, and that's this value right here, or it is equal to minus V0 minus over I0 minus, which is this same value right there. So the characteristic impedance is R prime plus J omega L prime over G prime plus J omega C prime square rooted. It has units of ohms. It's very important to understand what the characteristic impedance means. The characteristic impedance is not a resistance. It does not tell us about the loss on the line. The thing that tells us about the loss on the line is alpha, and that's not this. What it is telling us is a ratio of the voltage and the current that are on the line, and that's the voltage and current that's going in one direction or the other direction. So this is simply a ratio of voltage to current. It's telling us, for instance, let's suppose that I put 1 volt on this transmission line, and let's suppose that I have a 50 ohm transmission line. What does that mean? It means that I have a current that is 1/50th of an amp. It's just telling us the ratio of the voltage and the current. Now Z, impedance, is typically a complex number. What does it mean if Z is real, as it is in this case? What it means is that the voltage and the current are in phase. There's no imaginary part here. There's no e to the j phi term. That's zero. So if the characteristic impedance is real, it means that the voltage and the current are in phase. And in fact, they'll be in phase for both the positive traveling wave and for the negative traveling wave. The other thing I want you to remember is that this negative sign is not a mistake. What it means is that I0 plus is going this way and I0 minus is going back the other way. That's why you get the minus sign. It really belongs down here on the bottom, but of course mathematically it doesn't make any difference. So the characteristic impedance is the ratio of the voltage to the current. It is not a resistance. If my line is shorter or longer, it makes no difference because the ratio of voltage and current is controlled by the resistance, inductance, conductance, and capacitance. This is simply related to the actual values R, L, G, C, which are determined by the physical parameters and the materials that the transmission line is made up of.